Hello, today I'm going to be using a full MLS team in FIFA 23, Division Rivals. I'm going to start with a bench. I'm going to be running with Lorenzo Insigne as my first substitute winger. The gold card, because I was too broke to actually go out and get this World Breakers Insigne. Or I just really couldn't be bothered going to try and get that card. When there was other cards out I could actually get and would have actually been impactful for my team. Second player, not Bale. I'm going to be going for this Buanga in form. Not too expensive, so should easily get a spot on my bench. The next player, I have my club. First one is Seattle Sounders midfielder Christian Roldan, the rule breakers card. He should be coming in for both the midfielders. I mean, he works really well off the bench. Next card will be Ladero. Not a bad card. Next one, I don't want to get Jorge Campos. He's small, he's an absolute midget. And Galese, Orlando keeper, is much cheaper. And as an Orlando fan myself, I'd much rather use Galese. Right back, it's going to be Nick Lima. For fantasy card, came out a few weeks ago. Hopefully gets upgrades, but looks like a good card for now. Next center back, Walker Zimmerman. Card came out during the World Cup. He's not out anymore, so you can't really get him anymore. But I'm going to be using him in this team since there's not too many options better other than the Rafa Marquez for fantasy. That's a million coins, and I'm not trying to spend that many coins right now. Next player, we have the Foot Fantasy Kamal Miller. He got an upgrade. It's up to an 86 overall, 87 pace, 84 defending, 91 physical. Looks pretty good. Next card we're going to have is Sporting Kansas City left back, Tim Lebold. This card is currently, I think, level 20 in the objectives menu, so he's very easily acquirable if you're trying to get that card. Next player I'm going to put in this team is a certain Mr. Landon Donovan. He's a World Cup hero. I was looking at League, but I don't think he's going to show up there. I already have my club. I packed him for the hero pick. Let's change formation here so I can actually, you know, add the next player. The next player is another player I have in my club. I played Foot Champ, so I already got his red card. And his inform, Thiago Almada. Pretty good looking card. 91 dribbling, 90 pace. He's probably going to win MVP in MLS this season. And I hate to say that as an Orlando City fan. Next player is the Brazilian from Orlando City. Doesn't play here anymore, but Alexander Pato. Only reason I'm putting him in here over Buanga, because Buanga has better stats than Pato. But the 5-star skills. That's it all. All 5-star skills, everything. You need those 5-star skills. As striker, only one man. No. I guess there could have been multiple players, but no, we're putting Benteke in there. Very big player. Very strong. Got a 4-star skills, which could be useful. Didn't expect a player like Benteke to have 4-star skills. Left center mid, I'm going to Cam. I'm going with Giorgio Chiellini, his winter wild card. I mean, 4-star, 5-star. Not bad. And our next player is going to be Ricky Puig. I was really looking at the Moreno card before I started this video, but I think Puig, his stats are just great. So I think that's what we're going to run with. I'm going to play a few games of Division Rivals, and we're going to start the footage right now.
Okay, so I played 11 games with this team. It's total, including the amount of games I played off camera. But I've started selling the team. We've sold four players, back up to 60K. I'm not sure if I'm going to sell Ricky, Puig, Miller, and Benteke yet, since they're fantasy cards, and today's an MLS game day, so they might get upgraded. But I'm selling these guys, Insigne, Buanga, Pato, and Chiellini. I'm trying to sell Bellingham for maybe a team I'm going to build in the next video. But going through every single player, I'm just gonna rate them real quick. Galese, he did the job. I mean, there was points where he wasn't doing too well. Nick Lima, he got a goal, three assists. He was just overall very, very good at right back. Stopped a lot of stuff defensively. Zimmerman was the weak point in the team. Just very, very slow. Just doesn't do enough. Liebold, he's solid. He did a good job. He scored that one goal on a ridiculous angle. Very, very good defensively, though. Donovan, I expected a lot more from this card, but finishing, he did what he was supposed to. But dribbling, I mean, like, kind of what you get when you have an 87 dribbling card. Thiago Almada, very, very, very good. Very, very good. He was a lot better at CAM. Even though I played him on the left, I would recommend, if you do get this card, I would recommend playing him at CAM. He does a lot more playing CAM than he does on the left-hand side. Now going back to the transfer list, Buanga and Insigne were super subs. Buanga off the bench was very nice pace-wise. His agility was all right. Not anything you expect from a good card, though. Insigne also came off the bench. Gold card, not really too much there. Pato, not too good. I didn't like using Pato. Especially as an Orlando City card. And as an Orlando fan, I still didn't enjoy using this Pato card. Even though the 5-star skills, he just didn't move how to expect a 5-star skiller to move. Next is Chiellini. He was very good defensively, despite the fact he only had 70 defending. And attacking, he did exactly what I expected him to do. He scored a goal, got a few assists. Ricky Puig, 11 games. I mean, distributing the ball, he was great. Moving around the midfield, he was great. And defensively, he read a few plays. Kamal Miller's a beast. Kamal Miller's an amazing player. I love this card. He is amazing. I would recommend him to every single one of you watching this video. He's 17,000 coins at the time of recording. If you can get this card in your team, by all means, do so. 87 pace, 91 physical. Those are the stats. He is very, very good. Just moves so quickly. I'd compare him to Sergio Ramos. If he gets a few more upgrades, he could definitely be a player that you try and force into your team. Benteke, he did very well for me, but that's because I'm normally very good with these kinds of players. In my club, I have a good example of that with Sebastian Haller, 94 games, 130 goals. But it's just this kind of player, big physical presence. If you play a guy that can just run forward through one goal, using a lot of physical presence to be able to create more space, I would recommend Christian Benteke if you're using a team, maybe get be with Belgian players. But I wouldn't use him at this stage of the game. There's definitely a lot better players. But if you don't have fun with MLS, I mean, he did a really good job. So I mean, that's the end of this MLS team. I had a lot of fun. Played 11 games. Won, I want to say 10 of them. I think I lost one of them or drew one of those games. And yeah, I'd probably do play with this team again.